Hello!
Again from the beautiful madness of my living room, because this is the best lighting I can get in the house in the morning, and I finally convinced myself to film this intro. Today was a bit complicated because one of the kittens we're looking after that lives in the garden is in heat, and she's so desperate. It's been like 3 nights that we didn't manage to sleep at all, and because she's screaming all the time, it was a bit complicated to figure it out for filming. And now there is Andreas playing with her in another room, trying to keep her entertained until I get this done. I'll try not to lose too much time because I don't know for how long this is sustainable for, so I'm gonna just start. And today we are here because I wanna try an ink that I bought a long time ago now, possibly 2 years ago, but actually never got around to try it. While I was in Sweden, I think, I was really in a strong, deep, passionate research for the bluest ink I can find, because I wanted to use it to write in my journal, and also I wanted to draw with it, obviously. Because blue for me is so important, I really wanted to find one that is the bluest I can get. And I've been researching a lot, and throughout my research, the one that stands out the most is this ink that I found. Let's see if you can actually see. Oh my god, you can't. Well, I'm gonna film it separately. So this is called Baystate Blue ink, and it's made by Noodlers. And from the swatches I saw online, this seemed like it's gonna be really, really blue. Sadly, I don't find many inks that are actually completely waterproof, especially for fountain pens. This is though water resistant, which is good enough, so I'm always terrified to get like my drawings lost, or what I write lost in the future, very far, far future, or if they get wet for some reason. So the fact that it's at least water resistant makes me feel more comfortable. I don't know, I think too much far in the future maybe, but to try this ink, because I don't really use brush very much, I actually bought always at the time in this beautiful stationery shop, which is called the Pen Store, and it's one of the things I'm actually missing from Stockholm, because it's the most designery, beautiful stationery shop I've seen until now. I bought anyway one of these pens from Lamy. Again, maybe you can't see, but so it's one of those fountain pens. I just asked for recommendation. It was about 30 euros or a bit less. It's one of those kind of fountain pens which I didn't know the existence of until then, which doesn't work with cartridges. I thought this is perfect for it because obviously I have the ink, I'm not gonna have a cartridge for it, so you just put the pen in it and just look at it. Wait, I'll show you. Let's be thorough. Oh, this lighting is terrible. Okay, you unscrew the pen and you have this thing here. So you're gonna screw this one way or the other to actually, like a syringe, suction the ink from the pot. Like you put it like this inside and get the ink out of it. So that's pretty convenient, easy, sustainable, everything. So I decided to give it a try. Today I'm gonna make a sketchbook page with this ink and this pen. I'm gonna try to do it directly with pen without penciling first. This is something that I do sometimes, but not this often, because I usually like to compose my drawings first with pencil, at least for positioning, but this time I'm gonna try like this. I think I'll get to draw in the evening this time. It's not gonna be as well lit as this, but I use all the lights I have, so hopefully it come out well. What else to say? Well, I guess we can talk again when I finish, then I'll give you my thoughts about it. See you later.
Thank you.
god, this lighting make me feel like in 2000 when everybody was contrasting their photos this much to look beautiful. Oh, thank god. Ah, stop it. Okay, so I'm back and this is the actual page done. Ooh, finally focusing on it. So after all, this looks really cool. I guess the best way to see the blue is actually when you make a large area out of it. If you use the brush, I think it will look incredible, because when you use a dip pen, the ink is all grouped in a single spot, it's gonna look a bit darker. But overall, in this drawing, it looks really beautiful. And I try to include a comparison with another blue ink I have if I didn't throw it away, because obviously in camera it's a bit hard to tell how blue something is, but if I compare it with another blue that I thought was the bluest one I can get before, you can tell. This one is more towards purple tint than green tint as you usually find, so this is definitely very strong blue. I would say ultramarine blue, which I really like. I definitely use it. Okay, I found an old page from a sketchbook in which I used the other blue I used to have before. I realized I gave it away because it wasn't the kind of blue I wanted, but as you can see what I was talking about, this is like kind of green tinted a little bit, even in comparison to my nail polish. And then I tried next to it. This is the blue that I used for the drawings. It's so different. It's more like pure and more purple, I guess. You can totally see from here. This is all evenly spread. I actually used the back of a chopsticks. The back of a chopstick, not a chopsticks. So it's all evenly spread here. And you can see how beautifully bright it is. So this is the first pass, which is the most intense. And this is the second. I really definitely love this blue, and it's the bluest blue I tried until now. So highly recommend it. Just a heads up, it really stains. Like a microscopic drop fell on my finger. This is the result. Forever marked. I used Bristol board, if you're interested. I just like this paper because it's very, 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 very smooth. And I love smooth paper, like as smooth as it gets. I got such a big bottle of this, so I have to go through it all before even considering getting something else. At the time, I considered getting sample, which were really, really small. I don't remember why I just went for the big one. Maybe the samples were out of stock. At one point, this would be worth, and I don't think ink goes particularly off. Maybe I'm saying something not true, but hope is the last to die. Okay, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'm gonna go before the kitten explodes. Talk soon. Bye.